I tried to write to you with my fountain pen, but I could not pretend to be that formal. Conservative, but it does not conserve. The ink flows from it like gas from a Cadillac Escalade. And a fountain pen can't take the punishment when you bang it on your knee, beating out the rhythm of thought, the rhythm of pain. It bruises and bleeds. La 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 la. Will I try to write to you with my mechanical pencil overdressed nouveau riche? Tries to be more than he is, and you never can trust him. He can change his words with a rub and a sweep. And a mechanical pencil can't take the punishment when you bang it on your knee, beating out the rhythm of thought, the rhythm of pain. His heart breaks in little bitty tiny useless pieces. La 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 la. Will I am trying to write to you with my Bic, honest and clear, transparent as a child. And you can look right inside and see how much life is left. But you'll probably lose me before it's gone. But I'm gonna haunt you, baby. I might be underneath the cushions of your couch, or I'm under the seat of your car, or I'm at that place behind your desk. You know I gave you that African violet and you always overwater it, and the water trickles down the wall and hits the floor, but one day it's gonna hit the electrical socket and burn the house down. Oh yeah. And you can look yourself, I mean, the next time you see a big pen. And I happen to have, oh, here it is, I happen to have one right here. This is the very pen I'm talking about. I mean, the same design since the 1940s. I mean, isn't that amazing? Except the cap now has a hole in it, because if you're chewing on it, you know, like you say you'd be writing, you're like, I go right, and the cap's in your mouth, and it goes down the wrong way. So there's a hole in it in case it goes down the wrong way, which begs the question, what is the right way for the cap of a big pen to go down? And the intriguing thing about this is the six-sided way it's designed is the same reason they designed cassette tapes the way they designed them, because when it went sprongy and you had that extra tape there, you could gently take the big pin and fit into the sprockets just right of a cassette tape. It was amazing. And by the way, at my grocery store, the Kroger, at my home, after school starts, these things go on sale. They're $1, 10 for $1. This is the last thing you can buy for a dime, people. It's beautiful. And embossed on the side is the label. And on that label, there's a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on a barrel holding a pin. Paul, sing with me.
Little round-headed man on a barrel
holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. Erika, come on.
That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pin.
Me? I get to sing? Okay. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pen. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pen. That's got
a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pen. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pen. That's got a little round-headed man on the barrel holding a pen.
get ready to jump.
Little round-headed man on a barrel holding a pen that's got a little-headed man from Georgia going round the bend.